Okay, welcome back to the channel. So we have a Ford car remote control and the wife says it doesn't work anymore, so we're going to pull it apart and examine what's wrong with it. This will be, I believe, a contact problem. There we go. Okay, so let's have a look, see what's inside here. Okay, what do I see? That's interesting. I'm trying to replace it the way it was. Okay. Contact points. That's how it works. Okay, so what you got here is this little battery holder sits on this point here. So I'm just going to examine it under the magnifying glass and see what's actually wrong. I'm going to put a bit of solder on this point here and try and tighten this up, see if that works first. Is she being weird? Bianc, stop being weird. So I've just tested this, and it seems that there could be other issues. I'll try and remove the board, which I believe is a problem. So let's check these switches. For some reason, there's all gunk around here, and they're actually high quality micro switches. The years of abuse, and there we go. Okay, so you can see you got four quality micro switches here. They're brass capped. So they're pretty resilient. I can feel them clicking. Okay, so we know it's not that. So it's definitely a contact issue here. And now that I've got the board out, what I may be able to do is to actually solder the pin back to its seated position. So where it's come undone is okay. So we're going to try and re-solder it back in place. So it definitely was a contact issue. I've cleaned it all up. Put it all back together. Let's go and test it. Okay, so car's a bit dirty, so don't worry about that, but let's test it. Okay, open. Yeah, do the boot. Close. Boot. Beautiful. Yeah, so that was it, folks. Contact points had come loose over time in the unit. I've repaired it, re-soldered a few joints in there, and basically saved $100 and something, I guess, by doing this. So yeah, all good. Lock it. Unlock it. Lock it, unlock it, lock it, unlock it. Beautiful.